Dear students, we have already learnt in my previous video as to how to value the perquisite called rent-free accommodation. Now we'll take up certain problems. With the help of that, you'll be able to understand the valuation of a perquisite of rent-free accommodation properly. We'll take problem number one. I'll go through the problem. Just read out. Mr. Harsharaj is a district magistrate of Shamaga. So he's a government employee. He is living in a furnished bungalow provided by the government free of rent. That means rent-free. His salary is 1,20,000 per month. The rent of the unfurnished bungalow as per government rules is 2,000 per month, but its fair rental value is 17,500 per month. It's provided furniture costing rupees 1,70,000. Find out the value of rent-free house as a perquisite for the purpose of income tax. Here, you see, is a government employee. In the case of government employee, perquisite value is equal to the license fee or the rent as determined or as prescribed by the government rules. And as per the government rules, the license fee or rent that is prescribed is 2,000 per month. All the things should be ignored. His salary, fair rental value, all these things are to be ignored. So, what is the value prescribed by the central government? Government. So, that should be taken. So, Mr. Harsharaj is a government employee. Hence, the value of the perquisite of rent-free unfurnished house will be as per government rules. That is, it is stated in the problem that as per the government rules, the rent is 2,000 per month. So, 2,000 into 12, 24,000. As far as furniture is concerned, say, it is assumed to be owned because nowhere it is mentioned that rent is paid for the furniture. Therefore, it is assumed that it is owned. If the furniture is owned, 10% of original cost is taken as the perquisite value. Of course, excluding laptops and computers. So, 1,70,000 is the cost. Of that 10%, that comes to 17,000. So that should be taken. Supposing the furniture is hired, then actual hire charges are to be taken. That's all. Okay. So, a perquisite value of unfurnished rent-free accommodation as per government rules is 24,000. That is at the rate of 2,000 per month for 12 months. And if the as the furniture is owned by the employer, that is government, so 10% of cost of furniture. Therefore, that comes to 17,000. So, total perquisite value of that bungalow is 41,000 rupees. Okay, that is first one. Now, we'll move on to the second problem. From the following particulars, compute the perquisite value of rent-free accommodation. Basic. Yes, that should be taken for the rent-free accommodation valuation. DA, unless it is mentioned that it enters the retirement benefits, it is not to be taken. Bonus, it should be part of salary. Commission, part of salary. CCA, city compensatory allowance, that's also part of salary. Now, there are three possibilities here, or three situations. Assume, point A, SSC is a government employee, and the perquisite value is taken as 800 per month. As you already learnt, it is the rent decided by the government, that is as per government rules, that should be taken. So, 800 into 12. So, 9,600 is the perquisite value of that accommodation. Second one, the SSC is a non-government employee and the city's population exceeds 25 lakh. So, here if you look at the problem, the accommodation is owned by the employer. And when the accommodation is owned by the employer, what you have to consider is population of the city where the employee works. And it's more than 25. If the population of the city is more than 25 lakh, then 15% of salary is taken as the value of accommodation. Point C, the SSC is non-government employee and the population is 15 lakh. So if the population is more than 10 lakh and not more than 25 lakh, the perquisite value is 10% of the salary. So 10% of salary is taken as the perquisite value. If the SSC is a non-government employee and the population is 10 lakh, so if the population of the city where the house is given as accommodation, then you have to consider the population. Population, if it does not exceed 10 lakh, then 7.5% of the salary of the non-government employee is taken as the perquisite value. Look at the solution. So here, government employee and rent is 800 per month as per the government rules. So 9,600. Second one, okay, you have to take the salary. What is salary here? Basic, bonus, commission, and city compensatory allowance. DA is not to be taken because they have not mentioned that DA enters the retirement benefits. The salary for the purpose of valuation of rent-free accommodation is 1,08,000. Remember, you have to be very careful here. So you have to find out whether it is per month or per annum, or that way you have to be very, very clear. 6,000 per month, DA per month, whereas bonus is not per month, it is for the entire year. Even commission is for the entire year. Whereas city compensatory allowance is per month. If it is given per month, that should be calculated for the full year. So that's why basic is multiplied by 12. And city compensatory allowance is also multiplied by 12. So this point is very, very important because many times students make a mistake in this regard. Alright, so 1,08,000, it should be 600. So 1,08,600, of that 15%, so that comes to 16,290, 15% of salary. Look at the note. So let me make it very clear. It should be 1,800 as 600. So same thing. This one, same thing is taken here. It should be 1,08,600. As it is not stated that DA enters into the computation of retirement benefits, it is not included in salary for valuing rent-free accommodation. I already explained. As the population of the city is more than 25 lakh, the perquisite value is 15% of salary. Okay, now we'll move on to the second case. SSC is a non-government employee, population is 15 lakh, salary calculation remains the same, 1,08,600. Even here, mistake is committed. So 1,08,600 into 10%. If the population is more than 10 lakh but not more than 25 lakh, the perquisite value is 10% of salary. So this salary computation remains the same in all the three cases. So 1,08,600 of that 10%, that comes to 10,800. Yes, that should be 10,860. Sorry. Alright, next. The SSC is a non-government employee and the population is 10 lakh. So if the population is not more than 10 lakh, then it should be 7.5% of 1,08,600. Already you have learned the provisions earlier. So this is just recollection of what you have learned earlier and applying that in the problem. So 1,08,600 into 7.5%. That comes to 8,145. Note, as the population of the city is not more than 10 lakh, the perquisite value is 7.5% of the salary. We will move on to the third problem. From the following particulars, compute the perquisite value of rent-free accommodation of Mr. It should be Anu. Okay. Basic salary is 1 lakh per month, 1,000 per month. So that is to be taken for salary. DA, 50% of basic. So 1,000 into 12, 1,20,000. Of that, 50% is DA. That means 60,000. But entire DA is not considered for retirement benefits. Therefore, 50% of 60,000, that is 30,000, should be part of salary for computation of rent-free accommodation, perquisite value of rent-free accommodation. Bonus is part of salary, 2 months basic, that means 1000 into 2 or 2000. Okay, next commission 2% of turnover, that should also be taken, and therefore that comes to 1% of that is 10,000, so 2% means 20,000, that's part of salary. Medical allowance is fully taxable. Conveyance allowance, if it is fully spent for official purpose, it is exempt, not to be taken. But 50% only is taken, so unspent amount 50%, that should be taken. So 1000 into 12, that should be taken. Then he is provided with rent free accommodation. I'm sorry, here basic salary is 10,000, not 1000, so it should be 10,000. And even here, bonus for 2 months basic means 10,000 into 2, 20,000. Okay. He is provided with rent-free accommodation at Bangalore having population of more than 25 lakhs. That means 15% of salary should be taken as perquisite value of the unfurnished accommodation. Then cost of furniture is 50,000. And company pays 600 per month as higher charges. That means furniture is not owned by the employer. It is hired and then provided to the employee. Therefore, in this case, what is to be added is higher charges. So 600 per month into 12, so 7,200 should be added. All right, you see the salary, 10,000 into 12, 1,20,000. DA, 1,20,000 into 50%, so you will get 60,000. Of that, only 50%, that is half, is entering into retirement benefits, 30,000. Bonus, yes, 2 months salary, 10,000 into 2, 20,000. Commission, 10 lakh into 2%. Already I told you, 1% means 10,000, 2% means 20,000. Medical allowance, it is fully taxable, so 1,000 into 12. Conveyance allowance, 2000 into 50%, I mean 12 into 50%, so that comes to 2000 into 12 means 24,000, 50% of that is 12,000. So total salary is 2,14,000. So calculation of taxable value of rent free accommodation. So as the accommodation is owned, you have to consider the population is more than 25 lakh. See here, you can make out 25 lakh. Therefore, perquisite value is 15% of salary. 15% of salary, that is 2,14,000 into 15%, that comes to 32,100. Then here, as far as the furniture is concerned, it is hired one. In that case, actual higher charges should be added. So 7,200. And nothing is recovered from the employee as a rent. Therefore, it is not a concessional accommodation, it is a rent-free accommodation. So, this will, the taxable rent-free accommodation value is remaining the same. So, 39,300 is the value of perquisite value of the accommodation. Salary means here, basic, bonus, commission and taxable allowances. Only that part of DA which is considered for retirement benefits is included in salary for rent-free accommodation. Conveyance allowance, that is 50% is used for official purpose, is exempt. Therefore, remaining 50% is part of salary. As the population of Bangalore is more than 25 lakh, perquisite value is 15% of salary. As the accommodation is owned by the employer, population is considered for determining the perquisite value. Supposing the accommodation is hired one, then the procedure of calculation is 15% of salary or actual rental rent paid or payable, whichever is less. So here, of course, it is owned, therefore 15% of salary should be taken. Supposing the population is more than 10 lakh but not more than 25 lakh, then it is 10% of salary. Supposing the population is not more than 10 lakh, then it is 7.5% of the salary. As the furniture is hired by the employer, the perquisite value of furniture is actual hire charges. Cost of furniture given here should be simply ignored. So that's about solution to this problem. Thank you.